Please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get new video updates. Hello friends, in this video I am going to give a brief description on column chromatography, which covers definition, types of column chromatography, principle of column chromatography and application of column chromatography, as well as advantages and disadvantages of column chromatography. As we know that chromatography is a purification technique which is used to separate individual component from a mixture. In column chromatography, purification of component is done with the help of column. So this technique used to purify compounds depending on their polarity and hydrophobicity. So question arises here, what are polarity and hydrophobicity? The property of molecules having poles or being polar is known as polarity. A polar molecule is a molecule has two poles. Its one end of the molecule is slightly positive while the other end is slightly negative. A molecule with two poles is called dipole. Those molecules which repels water are known as hydrophobic molecules or non-polar molecules. Types of column chromatography. There are mainly five chromatographic methods which use column techniques, and I have listed those five ones here. First one is a gas chromatography, second is liquid chromatography, and third one is ion exchange chromatography, fourth one is size exclusion chromatography, and fifth one is chiral chromatography. Principle of column chromatography. Now let's see the instrumentation and principle of column chromatography. The most important component of column chromatography is column. It is tube-like structure made up of glass or borosilicate glass. One thing I want to clarify, that the figure is shown here in this video which has about 6 columns. Actually that is one column showing different stages of the procedure. The other important thing I want to tell you, that there are two types of column chromatography based on operation. First one is automatic and second one is manual. And in this video, manual setup is being discussed. Now briefing you the procedure and steps involved in column chromatography. On the basis of sample or analyte, the stationary phase is decided and mostly silica gel or alumina is used. Now let's know how the column is packed and steps involved to run the procedure. First, cotton layer is put here. After that, sand is introduced and thickness of sand is about 1 cm. In the next step, silica and solvent in the form of slurry is introduced, which works as a stationary phase. After that, once again sand is put on the top and its thickness is about 1 cm. And later on, sample is introduced. After this, sample is introduced and solvent is poured as per requirement on certain intervals. The sample has different component and molecules, and each molecule has different affinity or polarity with silica. That is stationary phase. So according to polarity, molecules move with gravity and collected in tubes. Once again, I want to tell you the principle of column chromatography in short. A sample mixture is taken which is set on the top of column. This mixture is made to absorb on the top of stationary phase. The separation of compound happened due to polarization of molecules. Application of column chromatography. Column chromatography is used in the purification of compounds and separation of molecules for mixture and using it in the formation of new substance. It is also used in DNA fingerprinting. Advantages of column chromatography. The main advantage of column chromatography is low cost, and this process can be used to separate any kind of complex mixture. Thanks for watching.